All right, I'm Nate Storey with Bright Agrotech, and today we're going to talk about propagation chambers, why they're useful, why you should think about using them, and how they can help you make more money. So this is a propagation chamber. It's a really fancy name for a very simple device. Essentially, all it is it's a cabinet that happens to hold some shelves and a water bath and a heating element. And what it does is it basically just keeps the inside of this nice and warm, usually about 80 degrees. We can actually set the temperature on the side with the thermostat, and that heating element will heat up that water and cause it to kind of vaporize, and it just kind of forms this water vapor, and you'll see how humid it is in here. Super, super humid. So when we take a tray like this, and we slide that tray in full of seed, and this one is just starting to go now. These are lettuce seeds here. When it just starts to get going, all these seeds will germinate kind of all at once in this nice humid environment, and we end up with product that's all the same size, germinates at the same time, and usually we get a little bit better germination rates than we would if we just planted in a dry mist bench or something like that. So this is a really, really great way, if you can put one together, or if you can afford one, to basically get good germination rates and good uniformity out of your seedlings. So we use this propagation chamber to get all of our seedlings ready for our bigger systems. And it's really, really nice because it takes the germination time from several days over the course of several days, where you have maybe have one seed germinating on day one, another seed germinating on day seven. So you've got 7 days worth of variation in size, which can be significant at the end of the growing cycle. It takes that and it makes sure that everything is germinating usually within a day or two of each other. So it shortens it all down. It also makes sure that we are germinating our seeds for a very, very short period of time. As soon as they pop up, we slide them over into the seedling system, start giving them a light, start giving them more nutrition, and let them really start to get going. So you can see how simple these things are. They're not really complicated. We're talking about shelves. We're talking about enclosed space. I mean, powder coated steel or stainless, and of course plastic because it's super, super humid. You guys can actually make your own, and a lot of people will do that. So depending on how handy you are, you can look at these things. There are plans online. You can build your own propagation chamber. You can also buy them if you're looking for something that you know is going to work right out of the gate and work for you and help you get producing better, more consistently, faster. If you're thinking about that, make sure you talk to us because we're using propagation chambers now. We kind of have some opinions. So if you're one of our greenhouse producers or one of our warehouse producers, you should seriously be thinking about a propagation chamber of some size to help start off your seedling production cycle. And the reason for that is if you're doing batch harvest, so if you're going through and you're harvesting, say, a zip rack of towers, or you're harvesting a zone of towers all at once, all at the same time, you want the lettuce coming out of there, you want the products to be coming out of there to all be the same size. And starting with a propagation chamber and exerting a lot of control over the germination process, make sure that when you get to the end of your growing cycle, things are much more uniform than they would be if you hadn't used this to start with. All right, so the nice thing about these is that they move as well. So you guys know that we're a huge fan of modularity at Bright Agrotech. We design as much of our products as possible to roll, to move, to be easily handled by people. So the nice thing is if you're growing in a warehouse, you've got nice concrete floors, you can get this going, pack it up, fill it up at your planting bench, roll it down to where you want it to live for the next couple days, plug it in, set it against a wall, out of sight, out of mind, come back, take your seedlings out, and move things around really, really effortlessly. So that's a big labor saver. And for those of you that are farming already, you know that labor savers are well worth the money. Hey, thanks so much for watching today. I hope we gave you some useful information. If you find these videos useful, please do subscribe. We love new subscribers. And make sure you're checking out our blog. We're posting all sorts of really great free information over there on how to grow, how to get growing, how to build a business around farming.